generally in the big inner city public schools, the artist, the scientist, the historian, the linguist, those children all get lost in the crowd. When we evaluate on the basis of their test scores, we've missed a tremendous amount of that person.
We have a non-meritorious method of defining merit in this country. We have tests that relate very, very strongly to family income and parent education levels.
We recognize in the College Board that there's other predictors that are very, very important, and sometimes even more important than a test score. Just as SAT scores over a long period of time have been a great predictor of success, Posse likewise can show you their students and show you their success in exactly the same way.
The American dream doesn't mean anything if people can be screened out of opportunities in life.
You can make it if you try.
I was raised in South Central, 7 children, and I'm the first to graduate high school and the first to go to college, let alone go to grad school.
You got to move if you want to be ahead.
This is where I went to high school. Crips and Bloods patrolling the hallways more than the deans would.
I never thought that I would go to university. Never. I didn't have the resources.
Posse has developed a strategy for identifying unbelievably talented young people who can succeed in college. It's called the dynamic assessment process. It puts young people into a dynamic setting. We're looking for communication skills and leadership and initiative and ability to work well in a team. And what we're finding are young people who are gonna take a campus by storm.
We all started screaming.
Everyone was hugging everyone.
And here's this bunch of kids all surrounding her and all crying. It was really, really a once-in-a-lifetime moment.
Knowing that 1,300 students wanted this scholarship and I'm one of the 10. My mom cried like so much, like if someone had died or something. We've been through it all, economic, emotional, everything, and still managed to go to college. So it means the world to us.
They get early admittance in January. And then it's our job to get them ready, which is 8 months worth of work as a group, building a team approach. We're going to graduate these kids like we have over the last two decades at over 90%.
When I first came here, I was really intimidated.
I feared that I wouldn't fit in, that my views would not be affirmed. I thought of dropping out. And then I'd hang out with my posse, and they're like, dude, you're all right. You'll be fine. You know, we'll all be fine because we're a posse. We're here together.
Posse started because of one student who said he never would have dropped out of college if he had his posse with him. Now, why not send a team of students or a posse to college together so they could back each other up?
The posse idea can be transformational, and it's really helped our campus. Posse scholars are bold, they're creative, innovative, they're outgoing. When you bring students together from a wide range of backgrounds and experiences, the conversations in the classroom are much more powerful. Everyone learns more.
In order for us to minimize all this hatred in the world, we need to be having these conversations. If we don't, we're stagnant and we're not growing as a nation.
Alex is a good example of someone who has done very well academically, been very active in student activities. He's someone whom students look up to. We're really fortunate that he's come here. They bring students with leadership qualities, and they help to develop those leadership qualities.
I'm a social psychologist, and I find that interesting, the stress on leadership. If you're a leader, you're somebody who can't really whine. You're supposed to find a way to overcome.
I came to Wheaton, and Wheaton said, well, there wasn't just Manhattan, there's the world. You can go to South Africa, you can go to Tanzania, you can do lots of different things. There is absolutely no way you can be an effective leader in the 21st century and not be prepared to deal with diversity.
We've been such a successful society because of our diversity, right from the beginning, from the nature of government to our literature. Take a problem like the achievement gap. Posse scholars, as they get in a position to be the researchers and the teachers and the school administrators, they have some of the insights that we need to solve that problem.
We love our college and university partners. This is a commitment. They are, by definition, the thought leaders in higher education.
Graduating from Carleton College, you have this brotherhood and sisterhood with so many people.
Posse goes way beyond opening doors of access in higher education. It really is a movement.
There aren't a lot of things in higher education about which you can say the results, the aim, the mission are unambiguous and it works. I think the Posse program is the greatest single idea in higher education in the last quarter of a century.
The thing about having a posse is that you're able to grow times 10. You're picking up strengths from other posse members, helping them with their weaknesses, which help you recognize your own.
Posse trains us how to be successful at transforming ourselves, our families, the institutions that we are a part of, and ultimately the world.
We're training these young people for the very qualities and skills that companies and corporations are looking for a leadership track position.
And in an organization like ours, where we have all different types of clients' experiences, teams that are different, teams that come to the table with diversity, get better answers. And Posse helps us find those people.
I think Posse is especially important because if we do things right, you can't even begin to imagine what this country is capable of achieving.
Tonight, we want to show you a unique program.
In the Posse movement.
I've really enjoyed watching the Posse Foundation grow.
We're creating a new kind of leadership network, one that this country has never seen.
This network of Posse alums can, in fact, spearhead decisions that need to be made in this country. I think that Posse is creating that network out there.
Barriers you've seen all your life start to fall. That's what I live for. That's exciting.
The battle that Posse is fighting is a battle that needs to be won if this country is going to reclaim its place at the forefront.
We need a Posse in every city in this country. I go to these award ceremonies and I see the scholars who return. I have such faith in the future because they are going to be there leading the way.